I played a very nice Yamaha Grand, and we simply balanced naturally all together. I was right in front of the cast in the tiny pit, and if I couldn't hear them, then neither could the audience. During the course of the run of 527 shows, we had a few changes of personnel on stage. Lonnie Donegan took over from Dennis, and then Lionel Blair replaced Lonnie. However, my favourite gals in dressing room number 6 remained constant. Janthea Brigden, Julianne Blythen and Stephanie Lunn. When I left the show a couple of months before it closed to work on Six for Gold, a new musical by Mike and his writing partner Warner Brown at the King's Head, the gals presented me with a beautiful glass inscribed "To Michael, Love Number 6. Makes me smile just thinking about it. They were definitely my favourites. Vivian, who died in 1996, was 80 in 1983 and wrote "Please, Mr. Cinders," especially for our production. He was a grand old gentleman of the theatre and a joy to be around. It was Dan Crawford, the Anglophile New Yorker from Hackensack, New Jersey, who created the King's Head Theatre out of the old back room come boxing gym in Islington, who brought Vivian and Cinders out of retirement. Dan was a man with great ambition and a visionary in theatrical terms. This was the first of many associations. We recorded the album for Cinders in Angel Studios. Norman Newell produced it, but he was concerned that the four-piece band would be too small a sound for the recording. There was a frantic day of scribbling in Mike's house a couple of days before the sessions, when Mike and Dick, with a little bit of help from me, hurriedly expanded the band to a six-piece by adding double bass and percussion. Actually, it was a really good idea. The arrangements kept their quirky 20s feel and simply sounded fuller with the extra players. The show was nominated for various awards, and again, we had to record a section for transmission on the Sweat Awards, Society of West End Theatres, television show.